Hello everyone, welcome to the OR course. Now in this lecture we are going to discuss the two-phase method. Here we are taking the problem. The problem is to solve the following LPP by using the two-phase simplex method. Here the object function is minimize z is equal to minus x1, minus 2x2, minus 3x3. Then the subject to the constraint minus 2x1 plus x2 plus 3x3 is equal to 2x1, 3x2, 4x3 is equal to 1. So far, we solved the problems by the constraints are less than or equal to type, or the constraints are greater than or equal to type. But coming to this problem, here these two constraints are equality type. Okay, in this class we are going to discuss how to solve these two constraints. If the constraint is a less than or equal to type, simply we take the slack variables. If the constraint is a greater than or equal to type, simply we take the surplus variables and artificial variables. Coming to our case here, we have only two variables. Two constraints are equality type only. That's why we are taking the only we have to take the artificial variables. Okay. Just while converting the constraint into while balancing the constraint for the two-phase or for the simplex method, just we take the artificial variables here. Okay. Why we are taking only artificial variables? The constraint is a equality type. So first we take minus 2x1, x2, 3x3 plus a1 is equal to 2, x1, x2, x3 plus a2 is equal to 1. While we are taking these artificial variables, it means we are going to find the basic variables, initial basic feasible solution while we are identifying the basic variables. For that reason we are taking the artificial variables. Here the Bayesian variables are called as the non-basic variables. For that the reason we have to take the artificial variables and slack and surplus variables. Here it is an equality type constraint, that means we are taking only artificial variables. Next, coming to the object function. Here we have original object function is x1 minus 2x2 minus 3x3. Now we are, and the function is minimization type. Here we are going to convert this object function to a two-phase object function, that is maximize z minus x1 plus 2x2 plus 3x3. Now we are going to solve a problem by the help of two-phase method. We have to convert this object function into two phases. Coming to the phase 1, after converting this object function, we get the artificial variables. The contribution value is minus 1, minus 0, which is minus, okay. Here now we are going to convert this object function into the two object functions. The first object function is maximize z is equal to minus a1 minus a2. Then the second object function is maximize z is equal to, other than this artificial variable, we have to take the remaining variables, plus 2x2 plus 3x3. This is our second object function. Here we use this into the phase 1, we use this into the phase 2. Okay, now here we are going to identify the basic variables and infeasible solution we are going to identify. Here the basic variables are x1, x2, x3. X1, x2, x3. These are the basic variables, and these basic variable value is equal to 0. And from these two, what are the x1, x2, x3, these are the non-basic variables, and the non-basic variable value is equal to 0. Coming to this, a1 and a2, these are the basic variables. These basic variable values we have to identify based on the non-basic variables. Here the non-basic variable values are 0, 0, 0. While we substituting non-basic variable value to the linear equations, we get a1 is equal to 2, a2 is equal to 1. This is our basic variables and initial basic feasible solution. Okay, next coming to the phase 1. Here we are converted maximize z is equal to minus a1 minus a2. Here we are taking the first object function. Then the constraints are same we are taking. What we are converting stage we have, those are we are taking here. Now we are going to the table 1. Here again, what is the table? In first column we have the contribution of basic variables, then these are the basic variables and this xv is the coefficient of basic variable, then this x1, x2, x3, a1, a2, these are the variables which are available in our constraints. Okay, and these are the coefficients of variables, those which these are available at object function. In this two phase, this is the phase one table. In this phase one, what is the object function? Maximize z is equal to minus a1 minus a2. Here only artificial variables are only available, then the remaining variables are not available, so that we have to take the remaining variable values are equal to 0. Next, coming to the basic variables, already we have calculated the basic variables from the linear equations. In this linear equations, we get two basic variables, that are a1 and a2. Those values are minus 1, minus 1. Okay, these are the contribution values of the basic variables. We get these values from the objective function. Next, coming to this xv, this is the solution value of basic variable. Solution value of basic variable means we are getting for these from linear equations. Those linear equations are the, when we are substituting the non-basic variables, l is equal to 0, we get these values a1 equal to mach 2, a2 is equal to 1. And coming to this, these are the coefficient values of linear equations. For first, coming to the first linear equation, what is the first linear equation? Minus 2x1 plus x2 plus 3x3 plus a1 is equal to 2. This is our first linear equation. Here, what is the coefficient of x1? The coefficient of x1 is minus 2. Then the coefficient of x2 is 1. Coefficient of x3 is 3. And the coefficient of a1 is 1. Here, there is no a2. That's why we are taking 0. Okay, next, coming to the second constraint. What is our second constraint? The second constraint is 2x1 plus 3x2 plus 4x3 plus a2 is equal to 1. This is our second linear equation. From this second linear equation, we have to take the coefficient values. X1 we have 2 and x2 we have 3, x4 we have, x3 we have 4, and a1 there is no a1, that's why we are taking 0, and a2 we have 1. So we are taking a1, a2 values here. Then coming to the zj, how we calculate the zj value? Zj means zj is equal to the contribution value of basic variable of I and 0 from I to j into, by multiplying the particular xij values. Particular xij. Here, what is the cv? These are the cv values. What are the xij? These are the xij. Here, we are taking the summation of this. Ij is equal to I equal to 1. Okay. Here, coming to this first one, zj, z1. This z1, z2, if we assume z1, z2, z3, z4, z5. Now coming to the z1, what is the z1 value? Z1 is equal to minus 1 into minus 2 plus minus 1 into 2. From this 2, minus 2, you get 0. Next, coming to the second one. Second one, what is the second one? Z2. Z2 is equal to same similarly minus 1 into 1 plus minus 1 into 3 minus 1 into 3. Z2 is equal to minus 1 minus 3 is equal to minus 4. This one. Okay. Next, same we are going to calculate Z3. What is the Z3? Z3 is equal to minus 1 into 3 plus minus 1 into 4. From this we get minus 7. Okay, next, z4. Minus 1 into 1 plus minus 1 into 0. From this z4 is equal to minus 1. Next, z5. Z5 is equal to 0 into minus 1 plus minus 1 into 1. From this also we get 1. Okay, next coming to the Cj minus Zj. If we assume C1 minus Z1, C2 minus Z2, C3 minus Z3, C4 minus Z4, C5 minus Z6, Z5, like this. What is the C1 value? C1 is this. C1 is equal to 0 minus Z1 is this. 0 is equal to 0. C2 is we have 4 minus 0. Sorry, here C2 is minus 4. C2 is, what is the C2 value? 0. 0 minus of minus 4 is there. From this we get 4. Next coming to the C3. What is the C3 value? C3 is 0 minus of minus 7. From this we get 7. C4, what is the C4 value? Minus 1 minus of minus 1. From this we get 0. Here also we get 0. Here the condition is not satisfied. What is our condition? Cj minus Zj less than or equal to 0. But here we have after two columns we have Cj minus Zj is greater than 0. That's why the condition is not satisfied. The current solution is not optimal. Now we are going to do the further iterations. For further iterations we have to remove the artificial variables. Whether the artificial variable is a leaving variable, we have to remove that particular column for further iterations. Okay, now we are going to identify the key row and key column. Okay, key row and key column, so we are going to identify. From this Cj minus Zj, which one is the maximum? 7 is the maximum value. Here this particular column is called as key column and this variable is called as entering variable. Entering variable. Okay, next. Now we are going to identify the key column. Key row. From the minimum ratio we are going to identify the key row. Here how we calculate these two values? These are the minimum ratios. Those are calculated from the key column and basic variable. Here the XB is 2 is there. First column 2. By the particular key column, what is the value is there? 3. 2 by 3. Next coming to this. 1 by 4. Which one is the minimum from these two? This is the minimum. So this row is called as key row. And this variable is called as leaving variable. And here we have one common point at key row and key column. That one is called as key element. Okay. For further iterations, now we are going to do the key element is equal to 1 and we are going to check the remaining values are equal to 0. Okay. Which one is the key element here? This is the key element. Okay. This is the key element. Now we are going to convert this value is equal to 1. Now we are going to convert this value is equal to 0. Here which one we are taking this key row? Key element we have to do the 1. How we do this key element value is equal to 1? By taking the iterations. Okay, here the minimum value is 1 by 4, it means 0.25. And here we get this is 0. Something. So this is the minimum. So R2 is the minimum. R2 new means we are going to get the new R2 value. R2 what is 4, where the key element is 4. Like this we are getting the 4 by 4. From this we are going to get R1 also. R1 new. Our table we have the 3 minus 3 into this. Like that. From this we get 0. We are applying these iterations to throughout the table. We get this table. Here X3 is replaced by, sorry, here in previous table we have A2. This one is replaced by X3 entering variable. Then the A1. Now again we are going to calculate Zj, Cj minus Zj. From this the condition is satisfied. Cj minus Zj is less than or equal to 0 all cases. So the improved solution is obtained in table 2 is optimal. The corresponding non-basic variables are equal to 0. Okay. Here ZJ is less than or equal to 0 and the artificial variable is appeared in the basis. Here the artificial variable is there and the solution is not feasible. Okay. If in this case CJ minus ZJ is less than or equal to 0 and the artificial variable is not available here, the solution is called as the optimal solution or feasible solution. We are going to find the optimal value. But in our case CJ minus ZJ is satisfied. But coming to the basis, here the artificial variable are available. Artificial variable is available. That's why phase 1 itself, the solution is infeasible. Here no need to go for further iterations. Okay. Just we start the problem here itself. No need to go for second phase. Finally, before the comment is the problem is not feasible. It means it is an infeasible problem. Okay. Coming to the summary, what we discussed in this class? We take the problem and we solve the two phase method. Here we are taking the problem is equality time. When we have equality time constraints, just simply we take the artificial variables only we are taking for solving the problem. Next, coming to the object functions, here we have to take two object functions. One object function contains artificial variables only and second object function contains decision variables, and if slack and surplus variables are available, we take those are also in second object function. Just coming to the phase 1, we are taking first object function, then we are getting the CJ minus ZJ less than or equal to 0, we go for second phase. When we get the CJ minus ZJ less than or equal to 0 satisfied in phase 1 and in the basis if we have any artificial variables, just we simply start the solution at phase 1 itself, then we call the problem is called as infeasible solution problem or not feasible. Okay, here in our case also we have this problem. The first phase itself CJ minus ZJ is less than or equal to 0, we get the base, we get this solution. Then coming to the basis, in the basis we have the artificial variable at first row. So that's why we call the problem is infeasible problem. So we are not going for further base. Okay, simply we conclude the problem here itself. Thank you.